Yeah, just hold them down there for a little bit.
Tom Miller and his family have worked this Colorado ranch for generations. There isn't much that Tom doesn't know about rearing cattle. Yet some very strange things have been happening to his animals.
There's so many things that I don't understand about it. And no one seems to be able to explain it either.
It first started back in 1999. Tom found one of his cows had died. On a cattle ranch, that's not unusual.
First, I thought it just died naturally. And then I got closer to it, and I could see it wasn't natural.
In 62 years of farming, Tom had never seen anything like this. Predators don't normally leave a carcass intact and drink 40 liters of blood. And yet farmers all over the world are reporting similar mutilations. Author and paranormal investigator Chris O'Brien has spent 20 years researching these strange incidents.
Cattle mutilations and livestock mutilations are a global phenomenon. In England, you've had horses and sheep. There were cases reported in Australia in the 50s. There's been approximately 2,500, 3,000 cases in South America since 2000. There's been thousands of cases in the United States going all the way back to the 50s. This is a very, very enduring mystery.
Ex-Deputy Sheriff Chuck Zukowski has been investigating this gruesome phenomenon in Colorado and elsewhere for over 28 years. His police training has led him to conclude that it cannot be the work of predators.
No one's ever seen a predator do that damage to an animal. And you learn a lot from the ranchers. These guys know how animals die naturally. When they see an animal that's been killed and they don't recognize any symptoms of how it died, it alarms them. This is their livelihood.
Previously, Tom Miller has had three mutilations on his ranch.
There you go.
Two were full-grown cows.
And the first thing a skeptic would say, well, mountain lion or bear. There are no mountain lions or bears anywhere near here. So there are no predators that could take down an animal in excess of 1,100 pounds.
Tom's recent case reveals new evidence that could point to humans being responsible.
One of the obvious things of this mutilation is the ribs right here are broken. They're actually snapped. Now, generally, when a cow dies, it'll fall over, but have you ever seen this type of damage before when a cow just falls over?
Oh, no, no, uh-uh.
Another thing we need to look at is maybe somebody was formed by through here in their pickup truck and it hit the animal, but you don't see any of that here, and we don't, obviously you didn't see any.
No, there were no tracks.
No tracks at all out here.
Many of the documented mutilations have similar unexplained bone fractures. Zukowski now thinks this can only be due to one thing.
The very first thing we look for is any type of evidence of the animal dying naturally. You want to see dirt moved around. You want to see scuff marks in the ground. Every one of the cases that are mutilation cases, there is absolutely no movement in the ground, no scuffing, nothing. And that tells you that that animal was placed there.
Which would suggest humans were involved. But there are no tracks leading to or from the carcass.
It just looks like it's been taken way up and dropped down.
Glenda Schneider, whose two horses were mutilated, also noticed something strange about the ground around the carcasses.
There was no tire tracks or anything going out to those horses. It was dry, very dry.
The animal's broken bones, the lack of any entrails or blood on the ground, and no tracks around their carcasses led Chuck Zukowski to an intriguing conclusion.
What I'm seeing is the animal's picked up from one location, it's taken to a second location, the damage is being done at the second location, mutilation, the unusual incisions, the removal of the blood. Then the animal is being brought back.
Who or what could pick up an animal weighing more than half a ton, cut it up, drain its blood, transport it, and then drop it back to Earth without being seen.
Seems to me like it something with aliens or something like that. If you say it's an alien doing it, some people think you're kind of goofy or something anyway.
However, Tom is not alone. Investigator Chuck Zukowski meets another eyewitness, a half-hour drive away from the Miller Ranch, who also had a disturbing encounter. Retired Sheriff Lou Girodo of Las Animas County, Colorado, is convinced that UFOs and mutilations are connected. He saw strange lights while investigating a mutilation.
A few years back, one rancher called me and said, you got to get out here, Sheriff. One of my steers mutilated. And then 15, 20 minutes later, a bright orange light came up, about the size of a beach ball. He came up off the ground, then he split in two. But it got me with it, the same size after they split.
Wow.
The one ball just went flying north. He just took off and he was gone in just a few seconds.
Did it make any type of sound?
Not even a humming sound. And I still think to this day, and it'd take a lot to convince me otherwise, it wasn't from this planet.
Oh, man.
Zukowski has plotted on a map the sites of cattle mutilations and then compared them to the locations of UFO sightings.
I started typing in the GPS coordinates of all these different sightings across the United States. And I was amazed. I couldn't believe what I saw. I started seeing a pattern, and as it appears, they were falling on a 37-degree latitude. Well, as it turns out, the top 10 states that had the most UFO sightings reported fall on that 37-degree latitude. We have Nevada, Colorado, Kansas, Missouri, Kentucky. And all of a sudden, I started to see this paranormal freeway shoot across the United States where all these things are starting to occur. It's remarkable.
For many of the farmers who have been victims of animal mutilations, this paranormal explanation seems to make sense.
I know some people think you're crazy if you say it's UFOs or something like that, or aliens, but I don't know what else it could be. I really don't.
Zukowski believes he's found proof of a link between animal mutilations and UFO sightings. He has a disturbing theory that he believes may explain why extraterrestrials might want the blood and soft tissues of animals.
What's interesting about cow blood is the hemoglobin. Bovine hemoglobin is used in vitro fertilization.
In vitro fertilization, or IVF, is the technical term for the fertilizing of a female egg in a laboratory in order to produce offspring.
UFO theorists believe that the cow blood is being used for hybrid fertilization, alien hybrids.
It sounds like science fiction, but certainly today, you know, we're doing things like gene splicing. So the theory is that maybe somebody else far in advance of us is doing likewise.